Hey everyone, and in this video I will show you how you can send a data from your MongoDB and store it in MongoDB Compass. Okay, so it will be a backend task and we will only use Mongo. Okay, so we will not use like any HTML or any other file, so we will only use the backend part. Okay, so to like add the data to a backend, you have to set up MongoDB. Okay, so in order to like start the setup, you have to install one dependency, which is Mongoose. So come to your terminal and write npm install, or you can just write I, so npm I, and write mongoose. Okay, and hit enter, and it will download the dependency. It is just it is used to like reduce the code and reduce the number of lines of code in order like to set up the MongoDB. Okay, so if you don't use this Mongoose, it will take you much longer. So after installing this, let's write the code. Okay, so make a file, any name, and write .js, and I will write a const here and I will give it a name of Mongoose. Okay, so Mongoose and is equal to require, and I will require Mongoose. Okay, so this is exact dependency which I have now installed. Okay, so that is the dependency. Then I will write mongoose dot connect. Okay, so this command is used to connect to the MongoDB database. All right, so you have to write bracket, and inside the bracket you have to write MongoDB, then semicolon, and then localhost 27017. All right, and then after write a slash, and then after the slash you have to give your database name. Okay, so whatever you want, you can give it the database name. So I will give it a tutorial. Okay, so you can give it whatever you want. Then you have to write then. Okay, you have to write dot then and catch. So we will use then and catch blocks to catch any error, and we will use this then block if our function is like correct and does not give any error. So what will happen, we will just write MongoDB connected. Okay, so if our MongoDB is successfully connected, then this message will be there. But if in any case it will give an error, so in that case we will write error. Okay, so if any error is there, so we will just write error in the console log. All right, and one more thing I want to tell you, this local host does not work for few people. Okay, so if it does not work for you as well, you can just write just remove this local host and write 0.0.0.0. okay, so 4 times 0. So in this way your problem will be solved. Okay, so if your local host is not working, you can try this also. All right, so let's move now. After like connecting to the database, you have to give it a schema. Okay, so what is a schema? The schema is the like your document. Okay, the way your document will be presented. So let's just make it. Okay, so I will say tut schema. Okay, I will just give it a random name. So const tut schema, then you have to write new and then mongoose dot schema. So as you can see, a schema, and then you have to give it an object. Okay, so it will take an object here. Then you have to write in what pattern you want your document. So let's say I want only name from the user. So I will give it name, and then I will give create an object here. I will write type. Okay, type that will be string here, and then I will write required. Okay, required true. Okay, so in this way, what it means that the type of this name will be string, and of course it will be string. Okay, and it is required true, so that means you cannot give an empty string. Okay, So in this way you can write a schema, and if you want you can create many more like objects here. Okay, so many more. So as you can see, if it is name, you can also write password and then email and anything. Okay, so in this video I will just write a name, okay, a single variable, just name. So after creating your schema, you have to create a model, or you can say a collection. So what is a collection? Inside that collection your all documents will be there. Okay, so let's write const collection. Okay, you can give it any name, I'm just giving it a collection. Then I will write new mongoose dot model. Okay, so you have to write model, this is used to create a collection. And then you have to, in this quotes, you have to write the name of your collection. So I will just write tute. Okay, so make sure the name of the database and name of your collection should be different. Okay, then after writing the name, write a comma here, and then you have to write your schema name. So my schema name is this, tute schema. So what it means, this collection will use this schema. Okay, so I hope you understand it. And then I think our like setup is ready. So let's save it and come down here in the terminal, and you have to just write one more dependency, which is node mon. It is not necessary, but you can like install it to like run your server more fastly. Okay, so automatically. And then after installing it, node mon, just write node mon and then your file path. Okay, so my file path is mongo.js. So hit enter. And yep, as you can see here, it is written here MongoDB connected. So that means our like server is running smoothly. Okay, it is not giving any error. So now if I'll just open my MongoDB compass here. Okay, so make sure to install this MongoDB compass here. Okay, so and after opening it, click on this connect button here. Okay, so click on it. Alright, so in the left corner here you can see all the database names. So this database, as you can see on the bottom tutorial, we have just created it now. And in this database you can see a collection named tute. Okay, so click on this tute, and as you can see here, there is no data here because we haven't like insert any data here. So now see how to insert a data. Okay, so we will just come down here in the collection. After the collection, you can just write collection dot insert many. Okay, so make sure the M is capital, and then you can just give it your data. So let me just define this data also. Okay, so I will write data, and you can give it an object. Okay, so I will give it name, and then you can say anything. Okay, so let's say techie, and then if I just save it, you can see it will not give any error. And let's see our MongoDB compass, and if I'll just refresh it, you can see there is one data and the name is techie. So that is how you can insert a data in your MongoDB compass. Okay, and let's see one more thing. Okay, before closing this video, how to insert multiple data at a time. So you can just create an array, and then you can write this objects here. Okay, so you can give it an objects, and then one more so as you can see here, there are three names. Let's change the name. So let's say techie web, and then dev. So there are three names in total, and if you are just giving it in an array, you don't have to write this square brackets here. Okay, so remove this square brackets from here, and now if I'll just save it. Okay, and now if I'll just refresh it, you can see there are a total of four data. So techie, web and dev, so all there, so all the data is there. Okay, so that is how you can insert one data at a time, or you can insert multiple data also. Okay, so I hope you like know how to insert a data. It is not a difficult task. And yep guys, that's it for this video guys. I will see you in the next one.